angel of the Lord brought tidings to Mary, and she conceived by the Holy Ghost. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and in the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and in the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and in the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of thy Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion may we come to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti, Amen. In tuo voluntari Dei, et in glitificabium tutum meum, iudicam et esse, et genu casumene, Judicam et esse in genu causum em decenti non sancta, ab nomine in condolo sorvo me. Quae tuus Deus votit in lumae, quare felicis, quare tristis in cielo, dum affligi me inimicus. Em de lucem tuum veritatum tuum, ipsum et lux erunt et lux erunt montum sanctum tuum in tabernacula tua. Et in tuoi volontari Dei, et en glitifica il viuvum tutum meum. Confite puti vincitra, Deus, Deus meus, quae tristis anima mea, ricordi conduvers me. Sverin del corde me toc videbo ili, salutari votus me et Deus meus. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. In tuoi voluntari Dei, et in glitifica iuvum totum meum. Auditorium nostrum in nomine Domini, qui feci caelum et terram. Confitio Domini potenti, Beati Maria, Sempigeni, Beati Mentari et Angelo, Beati Juan Battista, Sancti Sposi, Spetum, Paolo, Beati Juan, Maria, Viali, Omnus Sancti, Vobis Fratres. Qui becavo in imis cogitazione verbo tapere, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ed io prego, Beata Maria, sempre vigine, Beata Metane, Marcangelum, Beata Mivore Baptista, Sanctus Vosos, Petrus, Paolo, Beata Mivore Maria, Viani, Omne Sanctus Vos Fratres, orari probe, Domino Deo Nostrum. Miseria tutti, quindi, più tenis, eus, mis peccatis, tuis, brucete, vitam eterna. Amen. Confitio Deo Onnipotenti, Beati Maria Sempre Vigini, Beato Michele Arcangelo, Beato Ioanni Battista, Sanctis Apostolis Petro et Paolo, Omnibus Sanctis et Tibi Pate, Quae peccavi in imis cogitatione, verbo et opere, meo culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ed io prego Beata Maria Sempre Vigini, Beato Michele Arcangelo, Beato Ioanni Battista, Sanctus Apostolus Petrus Paulum, omnes sanctos et te, Pater, orari pro me, Domino Deo Nostrum. Miseria tu vesci, nipotens Deus, et mis peccatis vesci, produce vos et vitam aeternam. Amen. Indulgentiam absolutionem et remissionem, peccatorum nostrorum tibi vendam, et omnipotens misericors Dominus. Amen. Deus tu conversus vivificabis nos, et plebs tu laetabitur in te. Ostende nobis Domini misericordiam tuam, et salutare tu in te nobis, Domine exaudi ratione mea, et clamo meus et te venia, Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo, oremus. Cognove Domine in te, equitas judicia tua, veritate tua, humiliasti me, confide timore tuo, canes meus, e mandatis tuis tibui, piaci immaculati in via, quae ambulant in lege Domini. Gloria, Patri, Filio, Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, e nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Cognove Domine, quae equitas judicia tua, et veritate tua, humiliasti me, confide timore tuo, canes meus, e mandatis tuis tibui. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Gloria in excelsis Deo, et in terra pax omnibus bone voluntatis, laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te, gratis agimus ibi prote magnum gloriam tuam. Domine Deus Rex Celestis, Deus Pater Omnipotens, Domine Filio Unigenite Iesu Christe, Domine Deus Omnius Dei Filius Patris, qui tollis peccatum mundi miserere nobis, qui tollis peccatum mundi suscipe deprecationem nostram, qui sedis ad exerem Patris miserere nobis, quoniam tu solus sanctus, tu solus Dominus, tu solus Altissimus Iesu Christe, cum Sanctu Spiritu in gloria Dei Patris. Amen. Pax vobis et cum spirito tuo. Orde Deus. Clementissime Deus, qui beatam Elizabeth Reginam, interceteras egregias dotes, medici furoris sedandi prerogativa del colasti, da nobis eius intercessione. Os mortalis vitae, quam suppliciter petimus, pacem ad eterna gaudia pervenire. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum, Filium Tuum, qui tecum vivite regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Lex Libri Sapientiae. Mulierum fortem quis inveniet, procolet den ultimus filibus pretium eius, confidit in ea cor viri sui et spolies non indigebit, edite bonum et non malum omnibus iebus vitae sue. Quae sivit lanum et lindum et operator est consilio manuum suarum, patres quasi navis institoris, de longi portans parem suam, et de nocti tu rexit editque predam domesticis suis, et cibari ancilis suis. Consideravit agrum et emiteum, de fructum manuum suarum plantavit vineam, accinsit fortitudine lumbus suus, et operavit brachium suum, gustavit et videt quia bona est negotiatio eius, et non est sungue etore note lucerne eius. Manium suam misit ad fortia, digiti eius apprehenderunt fuxum. Manium suam aperuit in opi, et palmas suas extendit ad pauperum. Non intimebit omni sui a frigoribus nivis, omnes enim de mystici eius vestitunt sunt lucibus. Speculatum vestem fecit sibi, visus et purpurum indumentum eius, nobilis importis vireus quando sederit cum senatoribus tere, sindorem fecit vendit et cingulum tradit carneo. Potitur et decor indumentum eius, et redebit in die novissimo, ossum operuit sapientiae et lexemensiae in lingua eius. Consideravit semitas domus sui et panem otiosum non comedit, sur exerunt filii eius et beatissima predicaverunt, vire eius et laudavit ea. Vote filii congregaverum divisias, tu super gresses universas, paris gratia et vanes pulchritudum, milies timens Dominum, ipse laudabitur. Date de fructum manium suarum et laudem Deum in portis opera eius. Deo gratias. Diffuseres gratia in labiis tuis, proterie benedicite Deus in aeternum, prote veritatem in mansuetudinem et justitiam et educet emerabilite destra tua. Alleluia, alleluia, specie tua et pulchritudine tua intende, prospere procede et regna, alleluia. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo, sequentia sancti evangelii secundum Matteum, gloria tibi Domine. In illo tempore redixit Iesus discipulis suis parabolum hanc, simile est regnum celorum tapsarum absconditu in agro, quemque invenit homo absconditi pre gaudio ilius fabi, et vendit universe quae habet et emit agrum illum. Iterum simile est regnum celorum homini logatiatori, venenti bonas margaritas. Inventar autum una preciosa margarita, habit et vendit omnia, quae habuit, quae et emit eam. Iterum simile est regnum celorum, sagine missa in mare, ed ex omni genere picium congreganti. Quam cum in praeter esse deducente, et esegus litus sedentes, erigerum bonus in vasa malus aut in foras miserunt, sic erit consummatione seculi, exibunt angeli et separabant malus de medio justorum et mitent eus in caminum ignis, ibi erit flectus est inudentium. Inter existis ec omnia, dicunt ei, etiam, et inis, ideo omnis scriva doctus in regno celorum similis est homini patria familias, qui profetet ausarus sua nova et vetera. Laus, tibi Christi. Is the feast of Saint Elizabeth of Portugal, Queen and Widow. The lesson is taken from the book of Proverbs. A man who has won a vigorous wife has found a rare treasure brought from distant shores. Bound to her in loving confidence, such a man will have no need for spoil. Content, not sorrow, she will bring him as long as life lasts. Does she not busy herself with wool and with thread, plying her hands with ready skill? Ever she steers her course like some merchant ship, bringing provision from far away. From early dawn she is up, assigning food to the household, so that each waiting woman has her share. Ground must be examined and bought and planted out as a vineyard with the earnings of her toil. How briskly she girds herself to her task, how tireless are her arms. Industry, she knows, is well rewarded, and all night long her lamp does not go out. Jealously she sets her hands to work, her fingers clutch the spindle. Kindly is her welcome to the poor, her purse ever open to those in need. Let the snow lie cold if it will, she has no fears for her household, no servant of hers but is warmly clad. Made by her own hands was the coverlet on her bed, the clothes of fine linen and of purple that she wears. None so honoured at the city gate as that husband of hers when he sits in council with the elders of the land. Often she will sell linen of her own weaving, or make a girdle for the travelling merchant to buy. Protected by her own industry and good repute, she looks forward to the future with a smile. Ripe wisdom governs her speech, but it is kindly instruction she gives. She keeps watch over all that goes on in her house, not content to go through life eating and sleeping. That is why her children are the first to call her blessed. Her husband is loud in her praise. Unrivaled art thou among all the women that have enriched their homes. Vain are the winning ways. Beauty is a snare. It is the woman who fears the Lord that will achieve renown. Work such as hers claims its reward. Let her life be spoken of with praise at the city gates. And the Holy Gospel is a continuation of that according to St. Matthew. At this time, Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure hidden in a field. A man has found it and hidden it again, and now for the joy it gives him is going home to sell all that he has and buy that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is as if a trader were looking for rare pearls, and now he has found one pearl of great cost, and has sold all that he had and bought it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net that was cast into the sea, and enclosed fish of every kind at once. When it was full, the fishermen drew it up and sat down on the beach, where they stored all that was worth keeping in their buckets, and threw the useless kind away. So it will be when the world is brought to an end. The angels will go out and separate the wicked from the just, and will cast them into the furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Have you grasped all this? Yes, Lord, they said to him. And he said to them, every scholar then whose learning is of the kingdom of heaven must be like a rich man who knows how to bring both new and old things out of his treasure house. Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu mulieribus, benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Carissimi, beloved in Christ, welcome to this broadcast Mass as we said on this, the feast of Saint Elizabeth of Portugal. Born in 1270, 1271 to Peter III, King of Aragon. She was married at the young age of 12 to Denis I of Portugal. And until her death in 1336, lived an exemplary life as a Christian. She was a devoted wife, a devoted mother, a devout Christian. And indeed, she, when she became a widow upon the death of her husband, she entered religious life as a tertiary of the Franciscan order. She was noted for her ability as a peacemaker. She was able variously to broker peace between the royal house or notable members of the royal houses around that area of Spain and Portugal. She was noted, of course, too, for her charity, noted for her care of the poor, for her generosity and almsgiving. It was said that no one who petitioned her for help was refused, and indeed she kept an eager ear listening for opportunities to provide assistance. Her devout life particularly came to the fore in the area of praying for the souls of the departed. One story particularly exemplifies her dedication in this respect. Her daughter, Constancia, who is married to the King of Castile, sadly died at a very young age. Whilst Elizabeth and Dennis were on progress in their kingdom, a hermit called out to the Queen to tell her that he had had visions of her daughter in purgatory seeking help, namely that a year's worth of masses or mass might be offered every day for the repose of her soul to aid her through purgatory, that she may pass onward into the light, into the fullness of the beatific vision. Elizabeth, so moved, then arranged for, with Dennis, arranged for a chantry priest, for Ferdinand Mendez, to offer daily mass for the repose of the soul of her daughter Constanza, and a year later was blessed to receive, after the final mass was offered, a vision of her daughter entering the beatific vision. We, my brothers and sisters, ourselves might care to recall and indeed to practice this commendable devotion of praying for the souls in purgatory, of praying for the faithful departed. We know, of course, that they are unable to effect for themselves any change, as indeed neither will we be when we leave this mortal coil. There is a tendency, of course, abroad these days to an adherence to a heresy, a false doctrine known as universalism, which tries to suggest that eventually all souls will be received into the beatific vision, irrespective of what they did in their lifetimes, irrespective of whether they were good or bad. Such, of course, however well-intentioned, is a heresy, is an apostate doctrine, and it is, of course, extremely dangerous because those who listen to it or abide by it may fall into the trap of not achieving the holiness that they might achieve in this life through repentance, confession, and absolution. Indeed, my brothers and sisters, we do well to remember that we have only this life in which to achieve and work with and cooperate with God's grace for our salvation. It is not possible after this earthly life to expect to receive an opportunity to start again or afresh, as it were, with God, nor indeed to enjoy eternal life with Him, not in that new heaven and that new earth. It is only in this life, here and now, in the present moment, that we have the opportunity to choose, through the gospel, repentance and acceptance of God's love and mercy, and thus the assurance and the promise of eternal life with Him. Only in this life, and indeed, as I say, in every present moment. Remember, my brothers and sisters, in our reflections particularly during Lent, we are presented with various opportunities on a daily basis to choose or reject God's will, to choose or reject God's commandments, to choose self or to choose sacrifice, to reject self in favour of charity toward God, or indeed toward God and toward our neighbour. Several times our Lord himself admonishes us in the Gospels that we shall not know the hour of our death, we shall not know the hour of our passing. And thus, every Christian ought to strive to so live their lives that whenever their life might end, or whenever the Lord returns, whichever comes first, we may be found ready, we may be found prepared, we may be found waiting for heaven. This is variously achieved, of course, by cooperating with God's grace, availing ourselves of God's grace, particularly in those assured means through the sacraments of the Church, particularly, of course, in the sacraments of restoration, the sacrament of penance, and the sacrament of the Holy Eucharist. This is why, from the earliest days, the practice of daily Mass has existed in the Church. That we may, of course, avail ourselves of the opportunity to receive our daily supersubstantial bread, that we may receive that manna from heaven, that new manna, which gives us eternal life. If we are not, of course, able to avail ourselves of receiving Holy Communion on a daily basis, then we should at least seek to make a spiritual communion, which service, of course, we offer in these daily Masses. After the invitation to communion is an opportunity to recite the prayer of an act of spiritual communion. Also, too, of course, is there should be a desire on our part to maintain and to remain in a state of grace with God. So it is that whenever we feel it necessary, we ought to avail ourselves of the sacrament, utilize the sacrament of penance, the sacrament of confession, so that we do not leave, as it were, to the last moment an expression of sorrow or regret or repentance. All too often, my brothers and sisters, we are inclined, as our Iberian peninsular friends might say, mañana, 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 mañana. We are often inclined to put off till tomorrow what rather we ought to take care of today. And for fear, indeed, of not enjoying the beatific vision, we should, my brothers and sisters, on a daily basis, seek to keep ourselves in a state of grace. As we reflected after the Feast of Pentecost, to seek to cooperate with God's grace by opening ourselves to receive the gifts of the Holy Spirit, that we may exercise wisdom and prudence and understanding and counsel, fortitude, and that we might live in that piety and holy fear that is necessary for us to remain on the straight and narrow, remembering that holy fear means not to live afraid of God, but to live ever aware of his presence. And that ought, my brothers and sisters, to check then how we behave, what we say, how we treat others, what we do with our lives and with our bodies. Remembering that God is omniscient, God does see everything, God knows all, including the secrets of our hearts. And we should be striving, my brothers and sisters, after holiness, something that is so lacking in the Church generally today, is this insistence that there once used to be for the pursuit of personal holiness. The pursuit of personal holiness indeed is in many ways divided even within the church today. This is a great shame indeed. But this is how, of course, sin and the devil begin to take over and influence our lives. Several times Scripture tells us to be vigilant, to be alert, meaning to hold fast to that which is good, to keep up our fight against sin, the flesh, and the devil, and instead seek after righteousness. Seek ye first the kingdom of God. And we are promised, my brothers and sisters, that those who so strive to pursue after holiness, to live in righteousness with God, will be afforded every possible assistance from heaven. We have only to ask, we have only to avail ourselves, we have only to be open and receptive, as I say, to the gifts of the Spirit, and seek after the graces of God. Similarly, if we if the sacrament of penance is not readily available to us when we might otherwise desire it, then there is nothing preventing us from falling to our knees and praying fervently to God and making our confession to him then. For as the psalmist says, a humble and contrite heart the Lord will not despise. We may have every confidence, my brothers and sisters, that God's love and mercy is such that it is always available to us. We may always receive it, who are open to receive it, who seek it fervently, who desire it. And who desire it not through fear, but through love. Who are motivated to live in love and in union with God, both now and forever. Let us then, my brothers and sisters, take to heart the beautiful example of Queen Elizabeth of Portugal, that we too, like her, might become renowned for our charity, for our gentle disposition to those in need, and for our ready willingness to pray for those who have gone before us, that they may indeed receive the fullness of the assurances given to us by the gospel and promised by our Lord Jesus Christ, of that eternal life with God, for those who truly believe, for those who truly desire to live in love and in union with him, both now and forever. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Dominus vobiscum et cum spirito tuo. Oremus. Diffuseres gratia in labiis tuis, proteria benedixit et Deus in aeternum et in saeculum saeculum.
Thank you.
saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Un Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo, susum corda, habemus ad Dominum, gratias damus Domino Deo nostro, dignum et justum eis, de vere dignum et justum est ecove salutari nos tibi sempre et ubique gratias agere, Domine Sancte Pater omnipotens et aeternus Deus, per Christum Dominum nostrum, per quem est statum tuum laudant angeli adorant dominationis tremunt potestates, Celi cerunque vetute te beate serafim, socis ut actione concelebrant, cum quibus in nostris vocis ut emitius iubes te precamur, supplici confessione dicentes. Sanctus, 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 Dominus Deus Sabaoth, pleni sunt caeli et terra gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis. Benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna in excelsis.
peccatoribus.
Erram ia secula seculorum. Amen. Orde, spreciati salutaribus moniti divini soluzione fumati, adeus dice. Ad noster qui sinceri sanctificetum nomen tuum, et venia regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sic ut nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris. E ne nos inducas in tentazione. Te libera nos al malo. Erra mia secula seculorum. Amen. Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccato mundi, miserere nos. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccato mundi, miserere nos. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccato mundi, dona nobis. Ecce agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccato mundi. Domine non sum dignus ut inter subtectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et sendabitur anima mea. Domine non sum dignus ut inter subtectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et sendabitur anima mea. Domine non sum dignus ut inter subtectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et sendabitur anima mea. Brothers and sisters watching Mass online and unable therefore to receive the Blessed Sacrament, we invite you now to make an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love thee above all things, and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though thou wert already there, I embrace thee and unite myself wholly to thee. Permit not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen. Justitia, metodis iniquitatem, propteri unsi te Deus, Deus tuus, oleo letitia. Pre consortibus tuis. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo. Orde. Sassi asti Domine familiam tuam munebus sacris, eus caesmus semper intervencioni nos devove, cuius solemnia celebramus. Per Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum, Filium tuum, et te convivit regni ad humanitatis Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo, ite missa est, Deo gratias. Sit nomen Domini benedictum, ex omnugo tusque in saecula, ad honorem nostrum in nomine Domini, qui feci caelum et terram. Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus. Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Dominus obiscum, et cum Spirito tuo, initium Sancti Evangelii secundum Iohannem. Gloria tibi Domine. In principio erat verbum, et verbum erat apud Deum, et Deus erat verbum, hoc erat in principio apud Deum. Omni presso factus sunt simso factum est lingua factum est. In ipso vitae dat lux hominum, lux in terribus luce, et terribus erum non comprehenderunt. Fuit homo missus Deus numero ad Ioannes. Hic verit in testimonium, ut testimonium bibere, tu lumine, ut omnes credunt velum. Non erat ille lux, sed ut testimonium bibere, tu lumine. Erat lux vere, quae luminat omnem hominem venientem in hoc mundum. In mundo era autum unus prisum factus est, unus non coniovi. In propria venite sum non inciperunt. Quod quod autem inciperunt eum desforestatim filius Dei fieri quis qui creent in nomine eius. Qui non est sanguinibus, nec voluntati gladis, nec voluntati viris, sed externati sunt. Et verbum caro factum est. Et habitavit in nobis et vinimus gloriam eius, gloriam quasi unigenitia Patri, plenum gratia et veritatis. Deo gratia. Mary, for grace the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, for grace the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, for grace the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning, weeping, in this vale of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, thine eyes of mercy toward us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. O God, who art our refuge and our strength, through thy mercy on thy people who cry to thee, and by the intercession of the glorious and blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and St. Joseph, her spouse, of thy blessed apostles Peter and Paul, and of all thy saints, in mercy and goodness hear our prayers for the conversion of sinners, and for the liberty and exaltation of our Holy Mother, the Church. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Holy Michael, Archangel, defend us in the day of battle, and be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and do thou, Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, thrust down to hell Satan and all wicked spirits who wander through the world for the ruin of souls. Amen. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, have mercy upon us. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, have mercy upon us. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, have mercy upon us. May St. Elizabeth of Portugal pray for us. St. Catherine of Stenning, pray for us. St. Wilfrid of York, pray for us. St. Richard of Chichester, pray for us. St. Louisa of Alfriston, pray for us. Our Lady of Walsingham, pray for us. Our Holy Guardian Angels, pray for us. Our Heavenly Patron Saints, pray for us. Our Lady Queen of Heaven, all the angels and saints, pray for us.